You might think it unfair that forgiveness is reserved only for those most deserving.
But imagine the anarchy if everyone were afforded such mercy.
I think we should call it off.
Really? Is that what you think?
I swear to God, White.
I'm just being realistic here.
It's not like you to question orders.
Who put you up to this? Was it Red?
No. No one put me up to anything. It's just, this is the riskiest gig we've ever taken. Morale is at an all-time low.
And whose fault is that? It's your job to prepare the others. They won't know how to feel unless you tell them.
So you want me to lie to them? Because honestly, I really don't think we can pull this one off.
All right. You know what, White? Fine. Heist is off.
Green?
No.
That's okay. I'll go ahead and break the news to the team that you denied them the retirement they deserved. That you denied their capabilities after years of training. That worst of all, you denied me, the man that gave you everything, the man that made you into something special. Is that what you want, White? You want to turn your back on me after all I've done for you?
Look me in the eye, boy, and tell me that's what you want.
No. No. I don't want any of that.
White, you know it pains me to yell at you like this. But you understand how this comes across to me, don't you?
You're right. I'm sorry for bringing it up in the first place.
That's what I thought. Now get out there, grab some pom-poms, and hype up our goddamn crew.
Yes, sir.
Hello, Earth to White.
Huh?
You ready to find that damn book or what?
Yeah, you go ahead. I'll be right behind you.
You're back.
Don't act so happy to see.
Let's see. Well, look, you've earned yourself a heavenly... One moment while I check on Mr. Mikey's schedule. Ah, Red! So good to see you, hon.
I know. It's been crazy lately, hasn't it?
You're telling me. I saw the craziest lover's quarrel the other day. You wouldn't believe the things those neons said.
Drinks tonight? I want to hear everything.
I'm still here, you know.
I'll see you then, hon. Now go on ahead. I won't keep you from Mikey any longer.
Thanks, Gabby.
The hell was that?
What can I say? The ladies love me.
What are you two doing here? Rogue Neons don't need assignments.
Huh. I guess we don't. Why did we come here, Red?
We didn't want to arouse suspicion from the Believers?
Don't worry about all that. I'll handle the alibis. I already told the other angels what's going on, and they want to help too.
Whoa. Seriously?
This used to be our home, you know. We went the cowardly route, pledging our asses to the Believers so they'd spare our lives. But this ain't no life. And frankly, I'm sick of pretending it is.
Hell yeah, Mikey. Go off.
Anyway, I figure if I'm gonna get shown up by a couple of mortals, I'll do my best to help. It's what the big guy would want.
We'll do our best not to let you down.
Thanks again, Mikey. And we'll be getting the hell out of your office now.
I want to see it.
Welcome. Would you like to redeem a ticket?
Here's my ticket.
Splendid.
Actually,
so, where are we headed?
Looks like the page glows brightest when I point it north.
All right, come on out, Violet. We know you've been spying on us. It's not like you're very discreet.
I don't know what you're talking about! I'm just a cute little ghost.
I mean, technically she's not wrong.
You're not fooling anyone, Violet.
Ugh, fine, you caught me. But that's okay, because now I know all about your little rebellion against the Believers. Naughty, naughty, you two.
So what? You planning on reporting us?
I was considering it, but I think it'd be much more fun to watch you both beef it out here.
You know, Violet, if you want to join us, just ask.
What?
Yeah, Violet, come with us.
You can't be serious.
Hey, I told you before, despite your whack social skills, I don't want an enemy in you. Besides, you're clearly not doing anything else.
That's not true!
Come on, Violet, it'll be fun. We can use white as target practice if we get bored.
Hey!
Well, if you really want me around so badly...
Yes!
Just don't expect me to do any heavy lifting.
I should try making some hard ones. down. No scoped it.
Thank you.
first try, too.
Heaven is a trip.
Scoped it.
I spy something really tacky.
Is it Weiss pleather belt?
How are you so good at this game?
Okay, my turn. I spy with my little eye something flat.
Oh! Is it White's ass? I said, is it White's flat ass?
You okay, White?
Huh? Were you two saying something?
You mean you haven't heard any of our S-tier insults? What a waste of comedy gold.
It's true. I'm actually kind of offended, White.
Sorry. It's just some of my memories returned to me at the sermon. Only enough to piss me off, though.
Let me guess, were they about Red?
Hush.
I just can't believe I had to die before realizing how much Green was manipulating me. You keep telling me not to fight him, Red. But I can't let this end without him suffering for what he took from us.
heard what Mikey said. The true days of judgment were based around forgiveness. If we succeed in restoring heaven, well, eventually, you're gonna have to forgive Green.
I don't know if I can.
Forgiveness, smorgiveness. Restoring heaven won't change the fact that we're still dead. So, why not treat yourself to a little revenge? Some people just deserve death over forgiveness.
What do you think we deserve, then, for our past?
That's different! We were doing what we could to survive. We were victims of circumstance in a cruel, cruel world.
Green lived in that same world with us. I don't think forgiveness should be determined by things like who is or isn't deserving. We all feel and inflict pain. We can choose to fight this truth in an endless battle where there are no true winners, or we can make peace with it. The latter is the more difficult path of the two, but I think what you gain from it all makes it well worth it in the end.
I think I get you. It's like how you can never be a true gamer if you only ever play on easy mode.
I mean, if that's what you need to compare it to.
Bad.
Thank you.
even break a sweat. I should try making some hard ones.
Thank you.
one down. Didn't even break a sweat.
The page is glowing brighter than ever. We must be getting close.
Good. My feet hurt. Can't we take a break?
I can do that.
Oh, that's right. I stole some treats for us from Central Heaven.
Please tell me you got some of those peanut butter fudge things.
How could I forget? And for Violet, strawberry cream puffs. They were always your favorite, right?
Brought something for me?
I figured you'd come around.
Why are you being so nice to me? Don't you know how screwed up I am? You know I tried to get White to kill you, Red, and Yellow, too.
Violet.
All because I was scared that White would realize I'm the weakest link in the team and leave me behind.
Violet, wait. Hey, no one is leaving anyone behind.
Just let me go. I don't deserve any of this.
Look, we're a team. We're all we've got here. If you're willing to look past my mistakes in life, then I'm more than willing to look past your mistakes in death.
Really?
Really. So come on, quit pushing us away.
Thank you, White. For being such a chump! I'll be taking that! Yoink!
What?
She took the page!
I can't believe you fell for my little act! Serves you right for underestimating me. After all, what's a katana to a cute face and an arsenal of dirty tricks?
What the hell is wrong with you? Don't you want to help us break out of this endless cycle?
I don't want- want to help you do anything. I don't work for you. I've never worked for you. Everything I've ever done has always been for Green.
Green?
But he led you to your death.
You're wrong. I died of my own volition. I was more devoted to the business than anyone else. Yet you all treated me like a child. Green never paid me as much attention as he did you apes. While the rest of you got to go off on big, important jobs, I was only ever trusted with the junk. I could never become the killer I was meant to be, because Green was too busy training you, White. Even in death, you're all he freaking cares about.
So you decide to stab me for it?
No, White. I meant to stab you only after you've taken out Red and Yellow. That way, I would be the top Neon, and Green would finally shower me with praise. But you just wouldn't cooperate with my plan. So I had to improvise. Ugh, how annoying!
You would seriously kill your entire team for Green's worthless validation?
So, you were all so caught up in your own crap, none of you ever gave a damn about me.
That's not true, Violet. I...
Can it, Red? I know you were once just as hungry for Green's approval as I was. But unlike you, I didn't give up when White stole him away. Anyway, none of that will matter soon, because now I know the true value of the Book of Life. And once it's mine, Green will have to admit I was worthy of his respect all along. And then, we'll kill you both together. Heart.
Aw, oh, damn it!
Don't worry. Looks like she didn't hit anything vital. Almost merciful on her part.
Could you at least pretend to be more pissed?
You and I know what it's like to be trapped under Green's spell. It's a painful place to be.
We've got more important things to worry about right now. Violet's got the page.
White, don't move. Your wound.
Can't let her get the book.
White!
Not bad for a dead guy, huh?